Let us take a moment to talk about video game interfaces. To prepare for this show, I actually read the book Interface by Neil Stephenson. It wasn't actually about interfaces, but go read it, it's a good book. Have you noticed that video game interfaces of the last couple of years are god-awful, horrid, and oh my god, I hope everybody involved in designing them will burn in hell? I know that may sound a bit extreme, but so is subjecting people to hours of having to use horrible interfaces. So it evens out. There are several schools of thought when it comes to video game interfaces. One of them, for example, is the strategy game school of thought that goes something like, if we put an option and the interface is just one click farther away than the player would expect it to be because the player used that option quite often, then we have failed. And exactly what options the player wants to use constantly, well, that requires the interface designers to actually have an intimate knowledge of how the game flows, or at least have enough feedback from people playing it to know what to put in there. And it's not just real-time strategy games where a second, well, not even a second, a split of a second, a microsecond, a millisecond, a attosecond can mean the difference between losing and winning. It's even in turn-based strategy games. I remember when they were designing Elemental War of Magic, there were a lot of discussions about the interface and how to make the best use of it possible. How to cram everything in such a way that it's at the most one click away. And back then, the people at Stardock were praising Civilization V's end turn button because that button would morph into pretty much anything you would still have or could do in that turn. It handled things like zooming to units, zooming to cities, to research, to combat events. It made the game flow a lot faster, a lot quicker. You didn't rush through the interface through the map to find what you had to do, what you could do. You had it all in that single button, and that was a big thing back then. An amazing thing. Which is why you will see variants of such a button in most strategy games that aim to give you a better flow to the way you play. And then the people that made Civilization VI thought about it and said, you know what? We hate the player. Let's hide the unit selection tab thing under the unit names and never actually mention it's there. Yeah, let's do that. Screw 'em. Let's have the great people window need scrolling to actually fit all the great people on one screen at 1080p for no goddamn reason. Now, it may seem like I'm ragging on Civilization 6, so I'll stop now. Mostly because, thankfully, there are mods out there. There are people that actually took the time to fix what Firaxis could not do and would not do. And I believe has not done in the last expansion either. But hey, it's a strategy game. It's a turn-based strategy game. You have time. You don't really get pressured into necessarily using those options in such a way that one extra click will mean the difference between life and death, or at least, okay, it will make using them annoying. It will absolutely do so. But at least it's not what we now have in the action game, or usually the action RPG genre. On the background, you're now seeing Morrowind. Morrowind had an amazing interface. It was scalable. You could move windows around. You could make them whatever shape of rectangle you wanted. You could even make a square. You can change the size, you can decide where they would be, how they would look like. You had so much freedom, and you could fit so much text into those windows. You could fit entire conversations in just one window, always visible on the screen. It was amazing. It was, honestly, I do not understand what happened when they switched to Oblivion. Okay, I know what happened. They made a game for the Xbox 360. That's what happened. They had to deal with the limitations of the console, with the limitations of its control scheme. So they made something that was usable with a gamepad. And it was a horrible interface, and it is the main reason why I have not really played much Oblivion. That and that it can't stack clothes anymore. I would put a robe over my armor and my armor would just be unequipped. Why? That's not how clothes work. Morrowind taught me better. Daggerfall too. Daggerfall, by the way, horrible interface. And I would say that it was due to the limitation of its time, but much earlier than that we had Ultima Underworld, still working within the limitation of its time, with a lower resolution than Daggerfall, a much lower one. We're talking the 320s, the 300s, the low res, and yet it managed to have an interface that worked. It was based on simple concepts like drag and drop, an inventory that you just drag things around and equip them in a very natural, in a very easy to understand way, in a very effective way. You decided where things were, you decided where to put them. The only thing that was a bit difficult was casting spells. You had to do them on the fly, you had to remember the combinations, you had to click the button, and maybe not having a shorter shortcut for the different interaction modes, that was a problem too, but you had the F1 through F5 key, so I guess it worked. Not as well as in some other games, but it was okay. And it's still an interface a million times better than what they came up with for Skyrim. Skyrim was created with that interface under the assumption that people liked the iPod. That's what Todd Howard said. Todd Howard, why would you say that? Why? Bethesda made Morrowind. Morrowind had the best interface of its age of a game that it was. It was the only aspect in which it outdid Gothic. And it took that away. I know you have the limitations of a controller, but why not try to make an interface more similar to Morrowind within the limitations of the controller instead of making a horrible interface where you can't fit more than 3 lines of dialogue on the screen just to satiate your need to have a talking head in front of you constantly with 3 options that have basically the same meaning, dialogue and menus and inventories that are plain horrible. Navigating through the inventory should not be that much of a chore unless you made it that much of a chore. Ultima Underworld gave you enough rope to hang yourself with. Ultima 7 gave you that and much more because you could so easily lose things in bags. Ultima 8 as well. I'm not saying we should go back to Ultima 7 and Ultima 8 because you could quite easily lose things in those bags. But it was a system that made sense. It was a system that let you decide how complicated and convoluted you wanted things to be. Whereas now we have no choice. Even the modern interface for Skyrim is still at best at the level of Oblivion, which was still as deep and crap compared to Morrowind. We are hampered by the controller, which is funny because one of them has a touchpad, which you know you could use for inventory management. At one time, the Nintendo Wii U had a giant screen that you could use for inventory management with touch capabilities. Did that change anything? No. Now I'm not saying it's Microsoft's fault, but it's always been Microsoft's fault. Always. But changing track a bit, can something be done to bring back actual good interfaces? Apart from firing everybody that makes horrible interfaces? Okay, maybe it's not their fault. Maybe it's not the fault of the person that's making the interface. It's the fault of the person designing it, coming up with the ideas for it. Todd Howard. Don't fire him. And because, you know, Skyrim was popular and games with limited interfaces became popular, everybody started copying those, so we started getting worse and worse interfaces. And not just at a functional level. Here's the interface for The Witcher 1. The Witcher 1 had a horrible, oh god, bad inventory system. They patched it, they made it a bit better in the enhanced edition, so that now you actually had dedicated slots for quest items, so you wouldn't lose them, you didn't just not have room for them. This is The Witcher 2. Holy hell. I'll give you a second example. This is Dragon Age 1. It has a book-style, journal-like feel to the interface. This is Dragon Age 2. What the shit? It's like nobody told these people that a good interface will gel well with the aesthetic of the game. It'll keep you in the moment, in the fantasy of the world you are in. Here's King's Bounty's interface. It looks like it's part of the game. Here is DaVinci Original Sin's interface. Superb, you can even turn the pages on books and they move so smoothly and beautifully. That's dedication to a style, to an aesthetic. That is cohesive design. That is functional. Good. One of them's a bit of a low ripoff, but still good. These, however, they're hastily slapped together piles of trash. Aesthetically, I mean. Functionally, Witcher 2 is also a pile of trash, which coming from The Witcher 1 is amazing that they can make it worse. What's even more amazing is that a lot of games, older games, get a lot of flack for having clunky interfaces. Which, yeah, granted, the original XCOM may be a bit difficult to play now. It requires a few too many clicks and extra places to get things to work like they should work. The original System Shock, even with the extra patch for the enhanced edition, still has a couple of kinks in it. But you know what? Even though the interface was a bit cumbersome, it'll let you do things. It'll let you do complicated things. Other things than equipping an item, then showing you a stat, and they still did it while seeming like they're a part of the world, like they were meant to be there. And while at times they didn't make your life harder, they had the excuse of being made in an age where the mouse was a new thing, where graphical interfaces were still kinda, you know, not necessarily a decades-long established concept. A decade earlier, we were still a text, like inputting text instead of using mouse or keyboard. I mean, you still use a keyboard for text, but still, get the idea. So I can forgive some of the shortcomings of those interfaces, because what could they do? They did the best they could. But when it comes to more recent games, you kind of get a twitch in your eye that in current year, people still can't make an interface for a game that's good. I'd also mention that Dark Souls has, as well, a horrible interface, but people will just tell me to get good, because being slow and cumbersome is good game design? But even it actually manages to fit pretty much, well, not the inventory, but the statistics at least, they all fit on the same screen. They're all visible at the same time. Should I could have just added the inventory scroll thing a bit higher, so every tab could be visible, so I could just instantly mouse on the one I wanted. But again, it's a game limited by its control scheme, and that is a gamepad. A gamepad that hasn't evolved pretty much at all since the DualShock. Same layout, same basic functions. The progressive triggers are barely used by anything. It's stifling innovation, but I'll get to that in its own separate show. I'm curious, what's the interface that just drove you up the walls? What game absolutely made you go batshit insane because of how bad the interface was? It's Skyrim, isn't it? I know it's Skyrim. It's gotta be. And still sold so many copies, proving that nobody really cares about interface design. Why would they? It's like caring that you can be the leader of a mage guild without being able to cast most spells, or it somehow it manages to be shallower than Daggerfall and offer you less variety. But that's a story for another time. And hey, the best-selling multimedia property ever made, Grand Theft Auto V, has a completely ass-backwards interface that has two interfaces, actually. For some reason, it's got one on the phone, and it's got one on the M key, or the N key, I forgot which looks like it was cobbled together by a modder like half a day, and didn't really care about how it looked, and that's one of the most profitable games ever made. So what I'm saying is, interface design is basically screwed, so we may just well pucker up and hope it doesn't stink. Goodbye.